looking at our vertical menu bar, we've got our help window. And the main thing I want to point out here is it holds all our shortcut keys. Search window, pretty self-explanatory. You would just type in the name of the object you're looking for. The configuration window. When we open that, we see save settings and restore defaults. I want to check this box to set Honolulu as my default location. So every time I open Stellarium, my location will be Honolulu. Going back to our configuration window, I also want to change my time. When I open it up, it will have the system date and time. That's the Eastern Standard Time on my computer. I can make it 9 p.m., but I can also give it a time and date. I'm going to make it 12:26 at 3 a.m. or 9 p.m. Honolulu time. Now going back to my main tab, I'm going to save those settings. We also have restore defaults. Restore defaults will restore my location to Paris and my system time as the default time, but it will not remove any locations that I have created, like the Frugal Computer Guy location I created in the first video. It's only the defaults that will be reset. Under the Tools tab, we have a button here, Auto Zoom Out returns to initial direction of view. If that's checked, let's say that I'm looking at the stars going up, zooming in, zooming out, maybe I'm zooming way out, and I've lost control of where I'm at, and I don't know how to get back. With that checked, if I hit the backslash, it returns me to a 60-degree field of view looking south, where I started. The other checkbox I wanted to mention is this Select Single Constellation. When that's checked, it allows me to view a single constellation. The trick is, I need to click on a star in a constellation first. Let's say I click this one, turn on the constellations and the labels. There I can see the Phoenix. If I click another one, that constellation is shown. Now I've got two on the screen, but if I click on a star not in a constellation, they all show up. To reset it, I just turn off the constellations and click on a star on a constellation. Turn them back on, and that's how I can select a constellation one at a time. Sky and viewing options window. Notice we have Jupiter and the Moon right above our window. Looking in the planets and satellites, we've got show planets checked. If I uncheck this, notice the moon and Jupiter disappeared. The labels didn't just disappear. The entire planet disappeared. So I think we want to keep this on, at least for now. Down below, we've got labels and markers. Here we have the planets again. Unchecking that turns off the planet labels. But the planets themselves are still there. We can do the same with stars. Unchecking this makes the label for Betelgeuse disappear. Checking it again turns them back on. Under the markings, we've got art brightness. If we turn on the artwork, the default value is 45, but we can make that brighter. Making that brighter makes the artwork stand out a little more. Landscapes. A couple of things I want to mention here on the Landscapes tab. This is where the show fog is hidden. If I uncheck this, notice this fog will go away. So it's hidden here under the Landscapes tab. Other things to notice here are that we can change the landscape. And we can also make this the default if we want by checking the default checkbox. We can make the ocean if we're looking out over the water. We can also use the moon. When might we use the moon? When we go to the moon. I'm going to go to Iceland because that will position me nicely on the moon. Instead of Earth, we want to click that drop down, hit the M. Now the M five more times. Hitting enter, and we are on the moon. We see the Earth off in the distance as we're on the moon, and we can see the sun coming up on the left. Let's turn on the time and speed it up a little, and we can watch the sun come up over the Earth from the moon. And as it orbits around, I'm going to pause this, click on the Earth, center it, and zoom in a little. Now we can watch the sun orbit around the Earth. Thank you.